All right. Welcome to Late Night Radio, St. Louis, Missouri. It's summertime. We're at Lohmeyer Sculpture Park. I'm going to be kicking the tunes here for as long as I feel like. First up, we're going to do a little Paul Revere and the Raiders. This is called Indian Reservation. On this reservation, took away my way of life. Tomahawk and bow and knife, took away my native tongue, taught their English to our young. All the beads we made by hand. Nowadays made in Japan. A Cherokee people, a Cherokee tribe. So proud to live, so proud to die. How y'all doing?
Good. Sounding good, man.
Thanks, brother. All right. A little bit of George Michael. Do a little Careless Whisper. Dance again, baby, ain't got no rhythm. I know this is the end, so don't be afraid. No better than to cheat a friend, waste the chance that I've been given. I know this is the end, never dance with you. Don't dance with me, cause my feet ain't got no rhythm.
Don't be afraid.
Should've known better than to cheat a friend, cause my feet ain't got no rhythm. I know this is the end, I never dance with you.
Like, man.
man, that's live. I gotta go see that.
I'm Tyler, man.
Steve.
Steve, nice to meet you, bro.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Well. Sounds good.
Thank you.
How'd you get all that stuff down here? You carry it?
I've got it down to an art.
Need a wagon.
I've got it. I got the guitar on this side. I got a backpack for all the pedals that goes on this side. The amp in one hand, the stand in the other. That's a lot, yeah.
Yep. Who was that? What song was that?
That was Careless Whisper by George Michael.
Oh.
You would know it if you heard it. It's a saxophone.
I know who George Michael is.
Yeah, man. If you heard it, you would know it. It's almost like a really cheesy Lay You Down by the Fire kind of song.
I like it.
Yeah, I like it. I never liked it until recently. I heard it a variety of years.
Well, there's a lot of songs that I don't like till I hear them covered, and then it's like, oh, I like the way that guy covered it.
Same, yeah. Well, let's see.
When I learn a new song or something, I always look up covers and see how other people do it.
Oh, you play?
A little bit.
Oh, please, man.
No. Definitely not.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've never sang on a microphone, though.
You know what? I just started 6 months ago. It's weird. I can't really sing, so I just try to keep my voice low and just in the pocket.
Yeah, definitely.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely.
Because, I always tend to go falsetto, and then it ruins, like, it's just bad singing.
Yeah.
So, anyway. All right.
If you got a minute, I might have a sample of something I do.
Yeah, I'll pull something up. I'm going to play Emerson, Lake, and Palmer song. This one's called From the Beginning.
Thank you.
That pedal's just for that one.
For that note.
That one note.
It's awesome.
Yeah, I think it'll sound cool, baby. Just that. Did you find it?
Yeah. Can't really watch it. You'll get sick. I'm in a rocking chair.
Dude, those are cool. Did you make those?
I made that one. Cigar box.
Yeah, that's awesome. Are you playing a cigar box?
No, I'm just playing in a rocking chair right here. I just put it there, see what it sounds like on
that's cool,
on
man.
Video.
What song is this?
Something you'll know in a minute. Maybe longer than a minute.
I'm getting Ozark Mountain Daredevil vibes.
Purple Stage.
New Riders?
New Riders. New
okay.
Riders.
Cool, man. You playing the harp too?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. I kind of like the rock.
Think?
Yeah.
I think I sound like no, my wife does not let me sing. She's like, shut up.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
No, dude, it fits the genre.
And I do the same thing. I just keep my voice really low.
Yeah.
Because he kind of, it's way more upbeat when he does it. When
it's really pretty, man. Are you sure you don't want to play one?
No,
I'm definitely. Sure.
Do you? That's my kind of stuff too.
Absolutely.
Here's one that I'm in my rocker again.
What kind of guitar?
This is a Martin.
Nice.
This is the Dillards.
Oh, good. Oh, yeah.
You ever watch Andy Griffith?
Who?
Andy Griffith, the Andy Griffith Show.
Yeah.
They're the band that's on there all the time.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Dillard's.
Those guys were.
They're from like Salem, Missouri, I think.
Those guys are built different. Those guys can really play.
Yeah, they can really play.
Yeah.
But I learned a D minor chord just so I could play this song.
Nice. Yeah, man. I mean, I've been playing for like 20 years.
Oh, have you? I've been playing for about 4 or something.
Well, but you know what? I haven't learned anything new in.
That's my problem. I don't learn much new. I practice what I know. And
that's exactly what I was going to say, man. That's what I do, too.
I do get better at it, but, like, I can play the D minor chord now really pretty good.
I can
land on it without looking. And
yeah, I mean, it's hard to get to know how to move your fingers in groups. And
it is,
you
know. And I just kind of memorize a couple of chord progressions and just stick with that.
Same.
And there's about
10 billion songs
to
play with that.
Yeah. Yeah. I know, like, at least 3 of the Dillard songs are the D minor, C, F.
Dude, so many great songs are a combination of those chords.
Yeah.
You know, and then you, like, you know, like, you can just do a pickup off of one, put it back down.
Yep, I have. My pinky's about useless.
Oh, yeah. Same with mine. I never use it.
I don't hardly use it.
Yeah, if I'm going to lose a finger, it needs to be the pinky. I just started getting carpal tunnel because of this.
I thought that might be why you're wearing that.
Yeah. Let's see.
I know my wrist hurts sometimes, and I got to stop.
Yeah, I don't like stopping, though.
No, me either. Does the brace help?
It keeps my hand from doing this,
yeah.
And right now, it's just this.
Yeah.
Yeah, it helps me. Yeah, it does. Yeah. I need it to just go away entirely.
I can't really stand and play at all either. I've tried.
You gotta keep trying.
Yeah.
You ever play open mics and stuff?
No.
Oh, bro,
no,
you gotta go.
I'm way too not good enough for that.
Trust me. We've all, you gotta cut your teeth, that's good. You get around other musicians.
I've only played in front of, like, there's one guy and one girl that we get together every now and then on Wednesdays, and we'll play together, but can't really do much, you know.
As long as you're having fun with other people.
Yeah, we have fun.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm doing.
One of my buddies plays, he can play like some lead and stuff.
Yeah.
And he'll join in.
Yeah, I would recommend, you know, if you ever mess around, get a looper.
Yeah, my son does all that.
You know, and you don't have to get too much into it, but, you know, it's fun. It's not for everybody. I kind of like fucking with it.
I kind of like only carrying my guitar.
Amen. Amen. Although this is a great setup.
Yeah, it is.
This
it
took
looks,
me,
sounds,
not to be,
sounds good, man.
I took, it took me 20 years. I've been dreaming of a setup like this. The technology caught up. It's wireless. It sounds good.
Oh, it sounds
the
really
good. The guitar is wireless. The microphone is, I hate wires.
Sounds really good.
Yeah.
What's your favorite song to play?
Man, I don't know. Probably, right now, Bob Seger's Turn the Page.
Yeah, I like Bob Seger.
Yeah. That and, I've
seen him a couple times when I was a lot younger.
Yeah. Yeah, I do this cool loop I like. It's really the loop that I get into that I really like. Yeah, I'll play it. I'll show you if you want, man.
Yeah, heck yeah.
Let's see.
I ain't got nothing to do but find my car. It's got to be up there somewhere.
It just it sounds better down there, but... helps my hand to play it up here,
and I can reach frets better down there or up there.
You know what helps too with, you know, stage fright and all that? For me, I've been doing this thing where I pretend to be a radio host. My whole I'm late night radio. My name's Tyler, but I pretend to be like an 88.1 KDHS.
I was listening to 88.1 on my way here,
and it helps me get. So I'll be like, all right, thank you all very much. Welcome to Late Night Radio. I'm here in Lohmeyer Sculpture Park. We're going to be kicking the jams all afternoon. Next up, we have Bob Seger's Turn the Page. Don't forget to stay tuned for the Soul Selector. 314-664-3688. Give us a call. Let us know what you want to hear. It's your afternoon, too. That's the actual phone number, too. I've been listening.
But
it helps
are,
me
you
put
are
on
a DJ?
It puts me a persona on to where I'm not really.
Yeah. You, know, no. You said you do DJing?
No.
Oh.
I just pretend.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm doing to help me get over
that. Yeah, it sounds professional.
Thank you.
head, smokeless cigarette that I had. Here I am.
Like a thinner pick when you're picking those high notes?
Boy, you know, so these are the three.
I was wondering why you were changing.
Yeah, so when I'm not amped up, the green thick pick, because this is your natural amplifier.
Right? Yeah, I use it. I play with a thick pick too.
Sometimes when I'm doing like strummy chords, when I'm amped up, I feel like this has a nice. So round.
I did that.
Yeah, I like that. Good. You ever tried one of the sharp ones?
Yeah, I have. Yep. Yeah. For some reason, they catch on me. I'm not used to them, I guess.
Yeah. But then, you know, like in the solos, I need to have like a, I need that thicker one.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Then when I'm laying down the, this part,
it's just, what about when you're doing the chimes and stuff?
Chimes require a pick. This part needs the thumb. I feel like the thumb has a, and the rake.
I use my fingers almost 100% of the time.
That's so good. It's such a good sound.
Yeah. You know, I barely ever go to a pick.
Yeah. Yeah, it was cool too, man. I don't know if you ever seen one of these.
Nope. Record. What is that?
This is a Yamaha Trans Acoustic.
That's what hooks that all up?
No, this is just, this is all like, this could hook into any guitar that plugs in. What's cool about this guitar though, is without anything hooked in, check this out.
I have a Yamaha, but it's like it's a dropping guitar, you know.
Here it is, just regular.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll check this out. You hear just the smallest bit of reverb, and there's like a transducer or something in there that it's like carrying a hallway around with you, like a good little just rounds it off nicely.
Get the acoustics a little better in there.
I think makes it encourages playing.
Yep.
You should try.
So what does that do?
This?
Yeah.
This is the Bose amp. And
no wonder it sounds so good.
And this guy stores in here and it charges and when you pull it out, it's a wireless.
So that hooks that up to that.
This hooks this up to that.
I got you.
Now the thing is if you want to have pedals, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can't have a wireless thing because you have to go into it. Like the wireless thing won't speak to this. Cool thing about the Bose amp is it allows for these Y. This cable splits off into two pieces, this end and this end. So it's kind of weird, but it's self-contained. Like you can do the whole loop thing here, and it still allows us to be wireless. So
it took me a long time to figure all that out.
It took me 2 decades, my man. But I mean, like
son has like. Well, his is red. I don't know if it makes any difference, but he has one like that, and he'll play like, he'll lay down a beat and then click that beat on, and then he'll play lead along with it. And
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I think.
Yeah, I mean, that's just cool.
this, man. It's
said your name was Jason?
Tyler.
Tyler.
Yeah, sorry.
And what was your name?
Steve.
Steve.
Yeah.
I don't know how I got Jason out of that, but sorry, thanks for letting me listen, man.
Hey, bro, thanks for stopping and hanging with me.
Good.
Keep jamming.
Didn't there used to be like a amphitheater right here somewhere?
I think that used to be it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that looks like it maybe did used to be one. When I was in high school, we used to come party. I went to Lindbergh High School, which is not far from here.
I went to Kirkwood.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How old are you?
38.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm 65, so
yeah.
We were in there at different times. But did you ever come to this park back then? Because
we used to party. We used to come here and smoke weed all the time.
Yeah, we used to come here and party. We did like senior skip days here and other kind of skip days. And
yeah. No, I loved
the place. But no. I just, this is the first time I've been here in probably 40 years, and I was like,
really?
I barely remembered how to get in here.
I think the only thing I messed up on was sitting up in this spot. I'm getting chewed.
I had like these flying ants on me.
Yeah.
What's biting you? Mosquitoes?
Yeah, I think.
I haven't gotten bitten yet, but.
Well, Steve, man, that was a pleasure.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
We've been chatting with you.
Yeah, nice. Yeah.
Keep singing.
Tyler.
Hey, don't let her shut you down.
She shuts me down. You know what, though? I'm retired. She works, so I have 8 hours a day, and I play a little banjo too.
Well, there you go.
So
as long as you got your alone time to do it.
Yeah, and she don't let me play banjo at all when she's home. So I get my banjo in while she's at work.
Good man. That's how you stayed married. Yeah.
Thanks for letting me listen, man.
Anytime,
you're good,
brother. Thanks
good.
For stopping. Yeah.
Real good. Where else do you play?
This is it. You can find me popping up all around St. Louis in weird parks. That's
I often thought about me and my buddy talked about he lives out in Union, Missouri, and there's a Union Lakes, which kids go fishing there, and we drive through there when I go to his house, and we said we should go to the park and jam some because they got some really nice pavilions, and they got electric, and you know if you want to plug in.
Yeah, you have Instagram, you have Facebook, my man.
All right, brother.
Thanks for letting me listen.
Anytime,
man.
Anytime.
Cool. Good cover, Bob Seger.
Thanks, dude. I appreciate that.
I think that sculpture's been here since I came when I was in high school.
Big Red is the staple of this place. It's iconic. I should've left that thing alone.
you're gone.